వెల్కమ్ టు మనోహర్ మోటివేషనల్ థాట్స్. టాపిక్ లోనికి వెళ్ళే ముందు నా ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, బెల్ ఐకాన్ పైన ప్రెస్ చేయండి, అలాగే లైక్ చేయండి మరియు పక్కనే కనిపిస్తున్న షేర్ ఆప్షన్ పైన క్లిక్ చేసి మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ కి కూడా షేర్ చేయండి. ఫ్రెండ్స్, హాయ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, హౌ ఆర్ యూ? వెల్కమ్ టు మై ఛానల్. టుడే 10th క్లాస్ ఫిజిక్స్ సెకండ్ లెసన్ కెమికల్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ పార్ట్ 2 వీ విల్ డిస్కస్. ఆల్రెడీ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్ సమ్ బేసిక్ పాయింట్స్ ఇన్ పార్ట్ 1. టుడే ఇన్ దిస్ లెసన్ వీ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ద బ్యాలెన్సింగ్ కెమికల్ ఈక్వేషన్స్. సో హౌ టు బ్యాలెన్స్ ఏ కెమికల్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ ఇన్ దిస్ లెసన్. బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ టు ద టాపిక్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు నో లా ఆఫ్ కన్జర్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మాస్. సో వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద లా ఆఫ్ కన్జర్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మాస్. సో కెమికల్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ బై ద లా ఆఫ్ కన్జర్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మాస్. అకార్డింగ్ టు లా ఆఫ్ కన్జర్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మాస్, టోటల్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది రియాక్టెంట్స్ మస్ట్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు టోటల్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రొడక్ట్స్. సో దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ ఏ కెమికల్ రియాక్షన్ ద నంబర్ ఆఫ్ యాటమ్స్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ద మాలిక్యూల్స్ ఆర్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ యాటమ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఇన్ ద రియాక్టెంట్ సైడ్ మస్ట్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు ద నంబర్ ఆఫ్ యాటమ్స్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ద ప్రోడక్ట్ సైడ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద లా ఆఫ్ కన్జర్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మాస్. Briefly, we can say mass neither be created nor be destroyed. So, in every chemical reaction, all the number of elements in the left-hand side or reactant side must be equal to the number of elements present in the product side. So, that is the law of conservation of mass. Let us see how to balance the equations. So, there we must follow some rules to balance the equations. Those rules are, whenever a chemical reaction is given, we must write the chemical formula of the elements in each reactant side and product side. Correct formulas we should write, and then we have to verify that number of elements present in the reactant side and product side. So reactant side we should take as LHS, left hand side elements, and product side is RHS, right hand side elements. We have to verify that if any imbalance is there, we have to take the appropriate number as coefficient of that element. For example, we see hydrogen react with oxygen to form the water molecule. So how to balance this equation? First, we have to write the chemical equation like this: hydrogen H2 and oxygen O2 and water molecule H2O. So this is the proper chemical equation. That means it is not balanced, but the formulas, correct formulas we have written, H2 plus O2 gives rise to H2O. To balance this equation, we have to see the elements. What are the elements are undergoing chemical reaction? Elements and number of atoms. Number of atoms or elements in LHS, left hand side, and RHS, right hand side. So this is the process we have to follow. So what are the elements participating or involving in the chemical reaction in this? Hydrogen and oxygen. So this is one hydrogen and oxygen. Let us see, LHS means reactant side, okay na? So LHS, how many hydrogens are there? 2 hydrogens. And RHS, how many hydrogens? So these are the 2 hydrogens. So both are same number. But let us see, oxygens is oxygens are left hand side, 2 oxygens are there, and right hand side only 1 oxygen is there. So this is imbalance. That means it is not balanced equation. Not balanced equations are also called as a skeletal equation. So we must balance this equation by according to the law of conservation of mass by taking the appropriate numbers as a coefficient. Let us see, to balance the oxygen atoms, we have to take H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. So now 2 oxygens are there in LHS and 2 oxygens are there in RHS also. So let us see, but if you are taken 2 number in the product side for the hydrogens, the total number of hydrogen atoms are 4 hydrogen atoms, 2 2 is 4. To get the total number of atoms in molecule we must multiply this with coefficient 2 to the 4 hydrogen atoms are there. To balance these hydrogen atoms we have to take number 2 for this reactant side also. Now this is the balanced equation. So 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. So if you observe here 4 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms in the reactant side, 4 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygens in the product side also, right hand side. So this is the balancing chemical equation. Let us see one more example. So second example is when propane burned in presence of oxygen, carbon dioxide and water molecule are produced. So propane C3H8 plus oxygen O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. So this is the chemical equation. Propane burn in oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. Let us see what are the elements are involving in the chemical reaction. Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So these are the three elements are there undergoing the chemical reaction. Number of atoms of carbon 3 in reactant side, only 1 in product side, and hydrogen 8 atoms in the reactant side and 2 atoms in the product side. Hydrogen, okay, 2 atoms. Now oxygen, 2 atoms in the reactant side and 3 atoms in the product side. In carbon dioxide 2 oxygens are there, in water 1 oxygen is there. See this number of elements present in the LHS and RHS, there is inequality, so it is not balanced equation. Here 3 carbon atoms in the reactant side, only 1 carbon atom in the product side. So to balance this equation, first we have to take the number 3 carbons for the product side also. So C3H8 plus O2 gives rise to 3CO2 plus H2O. First we have to balance the carbon atoms only. So let us see now, carbon atoms 3 and 3 are there. Now we will balance the hydrogens also. Here 8 are there, here only 2 are there. Let us see now, to balance the hydrogens, C3H8 plus O2 gives rise to 3CO2 plus 4H2O. So in order to get balancing of hydrogen atoms, if you are taken 4 number, 4 to the 8 hydrogens. Now lastly oxygens also we will balance. Here product side 3 to the 6 plus 4, 10 oxygen atoms are there. Here only 2 oxygen atoms are there. To balance these oxygen atoms, C3H8 plus 5O2. So 5O2 means 5 to the 10 oxygens are there. So this is the balancing equation. So now you see carefully, all atoms are balanced now. C3, 3 carbon atoms, 3 carbon atoms. 8 hydrogen atoms, 8 hydrogen atoms. And 10 oxygen atoms, 3 to the 6 plus 4, 10 oxygen atoms. So this is the way of balancing chemical equations. So like that, any equation also we can easily balance. You must remember the basic principle in this. According to law of conservation of mass, we will balance the equations. So first we have to write the correct formula in the equation, and then we have to take the appropriate number to balance the equation as coefficient of that element only. Remember, you should not change the formula of the compound or molecule in the chemical reaction. So by taking the appropriate number as a coefficient, we can easily balance the equations. I hope you understand well. We will continue next part of the lesson in next video. Children, still if you do not subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel in order to get the regular videos of content of this physics or other motivational classes also. I wish you all the best.